So, we finally have all the answers. And yet, here I stand, feeling like I understand even less than I did before. This talk of the unity of a multiverse? Dead friends appearing again? It is all simply too much. And you think it is just that simple? It would seem to me that verifying this is much like verifying the idea of an afterlife. If this is all true, as the Starborn say, then passing through the Unity will allow one to know the truth. But whomever does that will then never be able to report that truth back to the rest of us. What good then does it do us? We did not, could not, have understood that our mission would bring us here. If this is true, it changes so much of what we know about the universe, and we have no way to know unless we make this leap. Even if everything the Starborn have said is true, if you pass into this Unity and come out in some other universe, look at who they are, at what they have become. They have the faces and voices of people you know, but are nothing like them. Are you not at all worried that the same fate would befall you? That you would become someone unrecognizable to the rest of us? Yes, I know. I can see it in your eyes. For your sake, I will try not to imagine the worst. Focus on the positives instead. But you must understand that I do not find this easy. We should get back to it. Now that we know what to work towards, there's no time to waste.
Research station, you speaking. What is your business here? What? We haven't sent a distress signal. Nothing on the comms. No other ships in the system since our last supply drop. Look, what are you trying to pull here? Research lab. All right. I don't know what's going on here, but you should talk with the director. For security, I'm going to have to ask your friend to wait out there. What's inside? Stay with me and don't make any sudden moves. I'll get the door. Welcome to Nishina.
It seems a strict policy, but in a way that is reassuring. Suggest they know what they are doing. Do not worry about me. Go ahead and go.
One now, one locked. Senior staff, protocol Delta. Use up. There. Be right with you.
Chief of Security. If you'll follow me, I'll show you to the director. We'll take the back way up. Here, you can see our lovely storage area. Don't touch anything. So, Nisha.
What the? Easy, easy. What the hell was that? What? 1 minute, you're following me, and then you're just gone. Minute later, you pop in out of nowhere, looking like you were in the middle of a fight. But there's nothing here. I should have never let you inside. What is this? Some kind of stealth tick? Who are you working for? Look, I don't know what's going on. Let's get you to the director. Maybe she can figure this out. Come on, this way.
Finally, someone came. The distress signal. You picked up the distress signal, right? What do you mean? Wait, how did you get in here? Hughes? Ethan Hughes? But he's dead. No. No, no, no. This doesn't make any sense. Unless... the accident. Maybe this is a side effect of the accident. If the probe is still feeding power to the distortion, then... Right. Sorry. 3 months ago, I was calibrating an experiment in our high-energy research lab. There was an accident. An explosion. It caused a gas leak. Sparked a fire. I was trapped in the control room. There was nothing I could do. They're all dead. The lab was built around a xenolith with a dense metallic odd.
Disappear! We should! Wait, he's back! All right, we're on our way up. He was out. I was just filling in the director. Let's keep moving. Let's go. This way. If anything happens, the director's office is on the second floor, end of the hall. You can't miss it.
Thank you.
This way.
Come in. Kaya Patel, Research Director. And this is our Chief Scientist, Maria Hughes. Ethan said you disappeared right in front of him. Twice now? Three times?
Director, you can't be taking this seriously. Look, I don't know who you are or what you're doing here, but there has to be a rational explanation for all of this. Excuse me?
That is quite a claim. What makes you think that? Tell us about this other universe. Raphael. Raphael died in the accident. He...
Wait, burned out? The leak. Director, there was a hydrogen leak right after the accident. It was contained in a minute or two.
But if it hadn't been, it could well have caused an explosion.
Another universe, though. That's a lot to swallow.
We're not sure.
Raphael was in the lab near the ventilation controls. He could have stopped it.
Maybe he did, or died trying.
You mean this other Raphael? No. How could we possibly do that?
Raphael was a colleague and a friend. If there was some way to help him, I would. But it does seem unlikely. This facility and the research level 2 kilometers beneath us were built to study a gravitational distortion. 3 months ago, our chief engineer, Raphael, was calibrating an experimental probe when something went wrong.
We still don't know what happened. There was a series of explosions, and somehow, it's still running. That would make sense. That's why the field strength keeps increasing. We have a control unit for the probe. After the accident, I tried to use it to shut down the system, but the kill switch isn't responding. We could shut it off manually, but the entire research level is locked down. We can't even get down there. Not from up here. The explosion fried the network circuits.
Without physical access to the research level, there is little we can do. We have been working in makeshift labs for months. What you see here are just our living quarters. Most of this facility is deep underground. We have a particle accelerator and extensive research and development labs. Or we did.
An artifact? Really? That's all you're gonna say?
No. Fair enough. You have a prior connection with them, then. Maybe that's why this is only affecting you. So far, no one else has reported anything unusual. Either it's your prior exposure to these artifacts, or, perhaps, simply the fact that you're an outsider here.
How? I told you the research level's locked down. We can't even use the damn elevator. What?
Clever. In this other universe, Raphael survived. He made it back from the lab. So clearly, his elevator works. Take it. And you might be able to shut down the experiment.
This is crazy.
But first, we have to do something about your shifting.
We can't shut down the probe, but we might be able to adjust some of the other parameters. It's risky. We don't know what we're dealing with, but...
All right. It's worth a try.
Then it sounds like we have a plan.
Come with me. The control unit is in the fabrication lab next door.
What have we gotten ourselves into?
It's you. What happened? You disappeared, and the ceiling caved in, and... I thought I'd finally lost it. What? How? Look, if you think things are bad up here, the research level is even worse. I barely made it out, and that was months ago. I don't understand any of this. If I hadn't seen you disappear with my own eyes, I wouldn't have believed it. Okay. You're my ticket out of here. We'll do this your way.
We can get out through the pantry. Here's the key. I'll back you up, I guess.
the...
Security breach! Everybody
go,
out!
Go!
Run for it!
Excuse me.
Look at this. It's going to take hours to clear this out. Assuming the rest of the building doesn't come down on top of us. How should I know? You're the one who keeps winking in and out of existence. I just want to get out of here. Go do whatever you're going to do. I'll see if I can clear a path to the door. I'm not sure. It might stop whatever's happening to you. It's a reasonable theory, I guess. They're a native species. We had an electric pulse field to keep them out. The fire took out the generators, damaged the foundation. They just keep coming. I was in the lab, working on the frequency calibration for the probe. I was walking out of the control room when it happened. I heard the tank's rupture. The alarm sound. I only had a second to react. I jumped back into the control room. The doors sealed. I was safe. From the gas. The fire. Everything. But I was trapped. There was nothing I could do to stop it. If I had gone the other way, maybe I could have made it to the ventilation controls. Killed the system. Even if it killed me. I don't know. I don't want to think about it.
It's you. You realize you just poked into my locked office. So much for security protocols. Sure. Down the hall. Take the stairs next to the atrium. Yeah. Let me get the doors for you. And done. Is there anything else you need? Yes, Kataxi. Nasty things. The original survey team ran across them. You're welcome to read the old logs if you want. Yeah, I'll unlock the terminal for you. The Kataxi in the other universe. Uh-huh. Wow. I've got an experimental thing one of the engineers put together. but... Yeah, I hope so. I'm trying to be reasonable here. Oh my God, you're serious, aren't you? I'm glad you understand the position I'm in here. All right. Yeah. It's never been field tested, but all yours. That's right. Has been since the accident. We can't connect to the control system to override it. The whole system's on a hair trigger. Camera spot anyone not in the staff database, they fire off an alarm, and all hell breaks loose. Bigger than you'd expect. We've got a particle accelerator, whole lab complex, the high energy research lab. Real state of the art. Can't tell you what a tenth of it actually does.
Did you get lost in the hallway? All right. This is the probe control unit. Most of these controls aren't responding. I'm going to very carefully adjust the settings I can. There's no way to tell what's about to happen. Pay attention and be ready for anything. I'll begin by adjusting the energy feed of the electron beam array. We're at 93 teravolts. Calibrating to 95, 97, 100. Nothing. Let's try the other way. 91, 89. What the? Okay. It looks safe to approach. But what in the world? Flux pattern matches the distortion in the lab. The setting is just exposing it somehow. Step into the distortion, please. Nothing. No, hold on. There's a slight pattern change. Some kind of resonance. Right, stay there. Let me turn the feedback up for a moment. Calibrating to 90, 91. Are you all right? So, the lower setting causes the distortions to manifest, and the higher causes you to shift. That seems promising. Keep it on the lower setting until you want to shift, and you should be able to avoid any more accidents. I'd give you my control unit, but it looks like you already have one from the other universe. Love to take a look at that when this is all over. If you can get down to the research level, you need to make your way to the high-energy research lab. Disengage the power interlocks, then pull the emergency shutdown to stop the probe. That should finally put an end to all this. Oh, and before you go, the director wanted to speak with you. Try not to get lost in the hallway again.
All set? If you need supplies, I've asked Dr. Barakova to take care of you. It's the least I can do after everything we've put you through. Before you go, there is one other thing we should discuss. If this experiment is the cause of your shifting, when you shut it down, the shifting will stop. What happens then? To you and to us. There's no way to be certain, but let's theorize. Nishina is a closed system, two potential states held in tension. When you shut down the experiment, that tension will resolve. You are the outside observer in the system. Whichever reality you are in at that moment is what will become real. For you and your universe, at least. The question is, which will you choose? If this were a choice between my life and Raphael's, I would ask you to save him. But as the director of the station, I am responsible for the lives of my staff. 30 people. People with families, careers, futures ahead of them. In this universe. It's not an easy decision, but I am grateful. Thank you. Now, it's time you are going. With the network offline, we can't shut down the security system on the research level, so you can expect some resistance. Be careful. Ethan, unlock the elevator lobby, please.
Ma'am, research level is still locked down.
I'm aware of that.
All right. Done.
Good luck, dear. It's been a fascinating day.
security lockdown is active. Emergency override controls are available on designated security terminals.
Thank you.
Security lockdown is active. Emergency override controls are available on designated security terminals. Controls are available on designated security terminals. Controls are available on designated security terminals.
Thank you. advisable to wear a hard hat. Please proceed with caution. This area.
Security incident resolved. The security lockdown has been terminated.
Welcome back. Ethan, how are we doing?
Research levels back online. Definitely some damage, but it could be a lot worse.
This is a lot to take in. Artifacts, multiple universes.
Look on the bright side, dear. Just imagine the papers you'll publish.
If anyone even believes this.
I am curious, though. Why did you decide to stay here, with us? Maybe so. Still, it must have been a hard decision. Our next supply ship will be arriving soon. I'll have a full report ready for them. For now, I'd like to extend our gratitude and what compensation I can offer for everything we put you through. Thank you. This has been a truly remarkable experience.